Hello and welcome. How are you doing? Today I'd like to show you that how we can fix this damaged front bumper in our car or in pickup truck. And now this bumper is plastic, and what we need to do first is that we need to take this bumper away in this car's front area, and then we can repair these holes and these crash things in there. And then we look a little bit closer to those crash things next. Okay, and here has been happened that in that area there has been happened big hit because this whole bumper, this plastic area, it is broken and there is this big scratch. And where it's like 1/2 inches or 1 centimeters at this wide and length this hole, and later I will show that how we can fix that thing. And then there was also second area in here. In that area there is also this cutting crash factory in that part. Okay, and we have at least two of those bad crash in that area. Okay, and then I continue. Okay, and then in this car, this Toyota Corolla, where this front bumper has been damaged, and I am planning to fix that. What I need to do next is that I need to take this bumper away in here, in that area, and next we need to go in here below of this car body, that we can take those screws out. And also it's good to start so that we open that bonnet. But first we go in this down area and we start to open those bolts and nuts. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and now we are looking in here down area, and we have next those bolts in here what we need to open. And let's go to look those closer. And there is this car's body and this bottom area. Okay, and then when we look in this bumpers, this below area in here, we can see that there is some bolts in here in that place, like in here, that area and in that area. And this is our first step, and for that job we need 10 millimeter socket, 1 0 millimeter, and that socket fits in these bolts, and these bolts are easy to open, and they open in here and they look like that. Standard bolts, and they keep that bumpers, this below area in this body. And we need to take all of these. Here is first, second, and there is third in here. And then we need to look also in that area. And here is also one bolt with what we need to open, and in that area also. And those bolts we need to take out. And then when we look in that area, where is this another, there is this front wheel in here. In that area there is also those bolts what we need to open, and I have already take those out. And this is the second step, that all bolts in below area away. Okay, and now I have take out all of these bolts, and now this bumper, it is moving because there is no any bolts in this below area. And then we need to go in this upper area and we need to open this car's bonnet, and let's go to do that next. Okay, and then my next job is to take this grill out in here, because this grill keeps this bumper in position. And then I take these grills. There is 1, 2, 3 screws what I open next, for that job I need this Phillips and this crosshead screwdriver, and there is this nice plastic screws, three similar, they look like that, and now it drops to the ground, and I take next this grill away. Okay, and then when I have take these grills screws away, I can lift this grill out, and then we can see more this bumper area, and here we can see one, and in that area the second screw, what are also those 10 millimeter bolts, and this opens so that I take my tool in here and then a little bit rotation and I open that screw in here, and now it opens and there is this screw in my hand, and it's quite normal, and then there was similar in there, and I open that, and then I recommend that it is good to take this headlight away, because there is some plastic, these fasteners in below of this light, and it is easier to control, and then we take that light and the side light away, and we need again 10 millimeter socket, and it fits in that bolt in here, and I open that first, it is now open, and then there is second step that we need Phillips screwdriver crosshead, and we open in here this small plastic screw. Now these parts are open, and then the side light opens so that I move my hand in here, and then in that area in here, and this part opens. I take a little bit better view. Okay, now the side light, when this screw is open, I little bit move that in this way, and then it suddenly moves in up. It is little bit tight, but when we move in that position in here, in that direction, and in here, it opens nicely. And then in that way, it opens out. And then in that side, we can see that there is also couple of in here, and in here, there is two 10 millimeters nut, and I open those. Here we have this nut, and it is the standard Toyota's nut in here, 10 millimeter, and then there was second in little bit upper, and I have already loosened these nuts that they are easy to open, and now when those bolts are open, I can lift that headlight in here, and of course, in that area, we need to unconnect this headlight, this cable wire, and it opens, so a little bit movement and pull out. And now this headlight is free. Okay. And then we are quite okay, because now this moves so nice, and there is interesting thing in this area, that when we move this light away, that when we move that bumper in that position, it opens, and then remember that in that area there was one nut what we need to open, and this nut is little bit different, it looks like that in my hand, that there is this, there is different, but the 10 millimeter nut also. And I have take that out in that position, in this direction. And there is this hole where it goes. And it is important to take out. And then when we move that our bumper in this front area, it opens in that position, and there is interesting joint, remember. And it's we must to move that in plain direction in here, because if we are too brutal and too hard, we can destroy this plastic ball in here. This is it. Look that, and we look closer that. Okay, and here was this bumper's support nut for this plastic, and here we have holes in this bumper in that area. This is this support nut. This is interesting. And now this bumper is moving, and then of course we need to take this bumper's this side-like yellow side-like bulb away also next. And let's do that then. Okay, and then when we have take those all bolts and screws away, we have a couple of things to do. First is that it's good to notice that this our bumpers, this locking is made by this kind of plastic, these things in here, like this plastic nose in here, what is in here, and it goes in these holes in here, and now this my bumper drops to down, and it is not dangerous, but it is good to take then this side lights cable, what is in here, it is good to take it out, and it happens so that there is this cable, and when I rotate that in this way, there is this bulb, and now this bumper is quite free, and it's in there in ground, and also in that area looks quite nice. Here I need to take also in here this bulb away, and now this bumper, and there is small washer fluid pipes what I need to unplug next. Okay, and now this bumper is free in here. I lift that away in this area, and then I move that bumper in my table that we can start to investigate those damage, and soon we continue. Okay, and there is this my bumper. And then when I rotate that here, I can notice that this bumper is high quality part, and it is because I can feel that this is very high quality product, because it feels so durable, even that there has been bad grass heat in here, that it has been went broken in that area, and also in that area in here. And then when I rotate that bumper in other side, we can see that what that looks like in that side. It is in there, and also in there, and it is similar in that area. Okay, and then my job continues so that when I rotate that in a little bit in this position, we can see in there this damage in here. And then we need to do in here, because there has been happened this grass, that this bumper's plastic has been went broken. We need now something spare parts. And these spare parts are like in here, steel plates where are ready those holes. And I have in different plates in here, and I purchased these plates in this hardware store, like Home Depot or Target or any place where is this metallic plates. And these plates cost something like $1 or €1 per piece. And then I found in one boat and sailing shop that there was this nice screws. Where is this interesting flathead, this side, that they are very easy to use with this repair, and there is this different sides, And also I need these nuts. And these my nuts are, and those bolts, they are, by the way, screws, marine accessories, and they are even stainless steel. And that means that they are really durable against water and any bad dust and things. And these are like boat and ship components. And they will work also very well in this my this repair in this bumper area. And then my idea is that when these parts are, that what I am planning to do next, the hint, that when these parts are like broken in here, like in that area, in here, this is broken, I am planning to install that super plate in here, in that way, in this way, and then I use this my screws, and I do in here nice holes, and then when I rotate that my bumper in back into position, and we can see that here is this fracture. I will insert that metallic plate in nicely in here hidden, like in that way, in here below, in this way, in here, in that way. Okay, now it seems that I need to first adjust that in right way, and then when it is in here, I will insert that metallic plate in here back area, in that way, and then screws in here, and then this my structure and this joint is very hard and durable. This is my idea. And then I am planning to add in here padding. But first I will do so that when I have in here this bad things like in that one, that I will insert that my metal plate in here below and in that way, and then I will add those couple of screws in here, and then padding in here, and final step is paint, and then this looks even better than this my current one. And let's look that what that area means in here. Because now this is really bad thing, and if I use something glue or padding, then this will become scrap and broken very soon. But when I use this metallic support frames in here, then till this will last very well. And I start my job, by the way, in that area. Okay, and soon we continue. Okay, and now I am planning to insert this my bumper, what has been damaged in that area in here. I am planning to insert that my bumper in this my workbench, what is in here. And then when I press that bumper in here, it is easy to fix these things in here and also in here. And now I will adjust this my workbench that is my bumper fits in there. Okay. And when this bumper is fine in there, we continue. Okay, and I continue soon. Okay, and now I have managed to insert that in here, and then I fasten, I press that my bumper in this position, that it is easy to fix that. And then I start my job in that, this upper joint in here, in that way. And let's go to look that closer. What I am planning to do in here, this is my issue area. And here is my metallic plate, and I am planning to insert that plate in here down in that way, and then I will add a couple of screws in here, and then padding in here, and it looks good. Okay, but first I need my drill and drill bit in here, and then I will do a couple of holes in here, and let's continue soon. Okay, and now I have in here my electric drill, and I am planning to do a couple of holes. And now there is this my steel and 1 or 2 millimeter thickness metallic steel plate, and I insert that in here below area, and then I adjust that my this damage similar than it was in before of this grass in that way, and I keep my fingers in here, and then I will do couple of these. I check that, okay, there is this my metallic plate in here down, good, and it goes in there well, and then I will do a couple of these holes in here. Okay, now this plate opens, and there is small area where I need to do this hole, and then I will do, and I check that can I use these ready holes, that I do holes in here, what match in these holes in here, and then I work in here a little bit, like 10 minutes, and then we continue. Okay, and now I have made in here couple of holes, what match in these holes. And then I insert my plate in here back, and then I start to insert my screws in here. And let's continue. Then I have inserted a couple of these screws in there. Okay, and now I have inserted in here this couple of screws. And there is my next screw, what becomes in here. And then I insert that in here, and then I adjust that it goes in there, and then when I have inserted in here all of these screws, we continue soon. Okay, and now I have inserted in here these screws, and then important notice, please note that I have special shape these screws, and then these screws, they will go in deep in this plastic. When I fasten, they goes like in inside in there. This is important. Look that area, this shape. This is different. It is not like this standard bolt. This is different sides, especially this upper heel area. And then it's important when we have this hole that we work with that quite long, that we can get that kind of very solid and tight joint, and we maybe need to do in new holes in here, but this is important that this joint is tight, and then we fasten these bolts, and then I will show that when I have fastened these bolts and I have inserted in this mold these screws in here back area, like in that way, that when I insert this screw in here, I insert that nut in here back, and there is this system what we have in here, that kind of joint, and it goes in here in this deep. Okay, and then I will fasten this, and then we continue when these screws are fastened. Okay, and then we can use that kind of support metallic plate in here below, in this down area, what is in there, and we can, by the way, look also in there what they looks like in there, if we can see, can we see anything, it's quite difficult to see, but the idea is that there are those screws in there. Okay, and now I am fastening these bolts. Here's my Phillips screwdriver, what fits in that position, in that way. And then I need in this back area this 8 millimeter socket, what takes contact, that my in this minute in this way, and it keeps that like in position. And then I insert my socket in here back area first. Okay, now it's in position, good. And then I start to fasten this screw, and look how this screw goes in this inside this bumper plastic. This is cool. Okay, now this moves. Okay, this is my trick. Look, this screw goes in inside in there, and it's goes like hidden. And then I fasten these all other screws next. Okay, and now I have fastened these screws, and as we can see, they are quite deep inside this bumper plastic material. And they are, I think, that very nice in there. And then when there is this steel plate in here, this down area, it makes this really durable and very stable structure. Okay, and then I need to do so that I need a little bit to add in here some padding in that area. And then this fix is quite okay and we can continue. Okay, and now we can see that there are those screws, and then we go to look in here this back area, that what these screws look like in here next. Okay, and now I rotate this my bumper in that area, and there we can see these my screws what are in this back area, and I have fastened these screws. And then it's good to do so that if we can use this locking nuts what is in here, where is this locking material, these locking nuts makes this joint more durable. And then we can also use like that we add in here two screws together in that method, and then when I fasten these two screws in there, then this joint is more durable and this bolt don't opens. It is the risk that if this bolt opens like in that way, it is bad. Okay, but there is this my joint, and then I need to add in here similar thing in that position in here. Okay, and then I continue. Okay, and then I have here that kind of metallic plate, but I have made a little bit curve so that I bend that my plate in here between this my hole, and now there is that kind of shape. And I even a little bit more bent that. Now it's fine, and then I think that I go to insert that in curve position. Now it looks in there very nice when this is in this bumper's curve position. And now we can do this support frame in here also. Okay, and when I am inserting that metallic support plate in here, I notice that in that position in here it is easy to do this holes in here that I can screw in that way easier in those holes. This first one, and then I insert in here some bolt in there inside that it is easy to do this job. And then I look that where are my screws here, and there is my screw, and I will add that in here in this position. Now it went through, and now it keeps in position, and then I do more holes. Okay, this is also hint that how to use these holes easily. Okay, hello, and next I am in that step that I have installed this bumper and this spoiler part in back, and here we can see those my repairs and those screws, and in other side in here we have these metallic plates, and also in here we can see that there is this repair and screws are in here, and I think that this is quite well process. And next step I have that I need to take sandpaper and little bit sand these areas, and after that I need to add in here this putty, polyester putty, and it's like, and with this putty I can fill these holes and these cuts in nicely, and the final step is that I can paint this bumper in that color. But next I take this my sanding machine and I sand these things, and here are a couple of my sanding disc what I am planning to use. This is the most hardest one, and when I rotate, this is P40, and this my sanding disc is this high quality Mirka, my favorite sanding disc. There is this Bulldog, and this is high quality sanding disc what come from Finland in this Europe area, and this is extremely high quality products. And in with that sanding disc and sanding machine, I will sand that first in this 40 hardness. What is in here, this number, that means that this is quite hard material. And then I have here a couple of others also. This is a little bit used one. And there is now all of this. Numbers are away, but I think that this should be 120 or 80, because this material is more softer than that one. This is very, very hard and harsh material, but this is almost very, very soft place in here. Okay, but next I will sand that, and then I will add in here this polyester putty, and I have here one example polyester putty, and there is this suitable stuff in here. And with that putty I can fill these holes and these cuts in here nicely. Okay, but next I take my sanding machine and I will finish this, and then we continue. Okay, and here I have more sanding disc. This is 220. But I started my job in this the most hardest one, what was this Mirka, and 40 is this size, and here is my sanding machine, speed control, okay, and then I install my disc. Okay, disc is there, and slow speed, there is speed control, and in that area first. Okay, good. And then that area in here. And then this area in here. Okay, and now these things, there is enough this hardness and endurance, and I take those moving particles away, and now this is quite much this scratches that this my polyester putty it takes, and this padding, polyester padding, it takes good contact in here, and then I need to also take all this dust and plastic parts away, and then I will add in here this my polyester padding, and then this surface looks very nice, and next I clean that area in my cotton cloth. Okay, and here I have cotton cloth material, and then I take all moving things away in here. This must be clean. And no any oil or anything else. And also in here. Everything must be clean, good. And then next I do my padding. I mix this polyester padding and hardener. And then I have in here this ready material and this paste what I am planning to insert in here next. Okay, and here I have my cup, and there is this gray is this padding, and this red is this hardener. And first I need to mix these two particles in together, and these are poison, remember, this is very harmful stuff, this polyester padding and this putty, because it is those gases and smell is harmful. And now I think that I have mixed this my mixture, and this is like ready for this installation, because this red material is away, and then I take my knife away. And here is my this tool, and then I take this my padding and this putty, and first I install it in here, and my purpose is to fill these holes. Is this my first target, that all holes I can fill and cover these things, and then when I have made that thing, I also fill this screw's head. It is important. And now they are end. Good. And this takes time to dry, something like 2 hours. Okay, good. And then I insert this padding in here, in this upper area. And when this padding is dry, I need to sandpaper this again. Okay, good. And then when I have filled these all things, this takes time, something like 10 minutes, we can continue. And after that we need to wait 2 hours that this padding is dry, and then I can sandpaper that again. And we continue then. Okay, and now my polyester padding, they are ready in there. And now I need to wait something like 2 hours that they are totally dry, and then I can sandpaper this again. Okay, and looks good. And then we continue. Okay, and then a little bit duct tape. And this tape protects these areas when I insert spray paint next. Okay, and soon I continue.